Life with Michael is a lot of fun and very hard to encapsulate in a couple sentences. I love spending time with family and friends, particularly a huge sports fan. I love music and movies of all types. I really just enjoy living life to the fullest and maximizing every day. And
thank you, everyone, and good evening.
I am a motivational speaker. I am the owner and sole proprietor of my own company, Michael J. Kalper Presents, Inc. I was officially labeled as legally blind at the age of 12. Everybody just attributed the vision loss to the cerebral palsy that I live with, and we thought they were right. I had gone for a routine eye exam with my low vision specialist because I was classified as legally blind. I had said to him that I was experiencing underwater sensations, or that things that I would look at would appear to be underwater. The low vision specialist takes one look in my eyes and says to me, "Has anybody ever diagnosed you with a retinal degenerative disease?" His last words being, "Barring medical advancements, you're probably going to slowly and permanently lose your sight."
Inherited retinal degenerations are diseases of the retina. So the retina, you can think of it as kind of a complicated machine, even though it's very small and biologic. And like any machine, it's made up of many, many parts. If one of the genes that's needed to make the retina work, for example, one of the genes needed for vision in the retina, is misspelled or broken, then that part of the retina is dysfunctional. So the retina may not work as well as it should, so vision is degraded. But then just like having a broken part in an automobile engine, if the part's broken, over time it's going to rub up against other parts, and eventually the whole engine will break down. And that's what happens in the retina. The past 30 years has seen an explosion of understanding of the genetic causes of these disorders, and in turn that has led to really the first chance to develop therapies that can be effective for them.
So we're off to a great start.
Throughout history, we've been trying to treat genetic diseases by treating the symptoms or the other problems that come up. But with CRISPR, we have the opportunity to potentially treat the root cause of the disease. So we have this DNA editing toolkit that's more efficient than it's ever been before, and we're trying to take it inside the body.
The current study is the first use of CRISPR for any condition used directly in patients. We're really excited and hopeful that this will provide a benefit to patients and offer hope for patients with these blinding conditions.
So the Brilliance trial is focused on testing the use of CRISPR-Cas9 genome editing to treat a specific genetic form of inherited retinal degeneration. So in order to participate in the Brilliance trial, subjects need to have that mutation in the CEP290 gene, as well as to meet other inclusion criteria, such as their level of vision and the status of the structure of their retinas.
So when I was accepted into the CRISPR trial, knowing that I was going to be among the first 20 or so people to receive this procedure, I wanted to go as soon as I possibly could. My parents, who were with me in the interview with Dr. Pierce, I literally remember looking at them and smiling, going, "This is a tremendous opportunity. What do I have to lose? Without this procedure, I'm going to go blind anyway."
If you step back a minute, the way that this all works almost sounds like science fiction. You have DNA editing tools that have been created in the laboratory. That DNA is put into bacteria, grown up, packaged into a virus that's very good at injecting DNA into cells. I get 3 drops of clear liquid that contains hundreds of billions of copies of that virus with the DNA inside. I inject it underneath the retina. The viruses in those drops are very good at injecting DNA into retinal cells. The DNA gets into retinal cells. The gene editing machinery is produced from that DNA. The gene editing machinery then finds that one spot in the genome that needs to be removed and cuts it up, restoring the ability of those cells to produce that gene and to produce the protein needed for the health of those light-sensing cells.
Prior to the surgery, I had no expectation. I was just the happiest person in the world to even receive the treatment. I knew it was experimental, fully understand that I'm still the second person in the world to receive it.
It's really exciting to see these breakthroughs for inherited retinal disorders, the possibility of treatment. It's a really exciting field for our young clinicians and scientists to enter. And of course, we all want to help patients, and being able to offer a treatment to patients and families when you've had nothing in the past really is a remarkable advance.
So it's very exciting to be working in a time when the lab research we've done to understand genetic cause of disease and develop therapies is coming to fruition. We're bringing the results of our research to patients. you know, in terms of a career goal, that's living a dream.
These clinical trials run on huge amounts of teamwork. So it's not only the team of doctors here at Mass Eye and Ear, it's us, plus the technicians, plus the research staff, even down to the administration. It's built on layers and layers of people all working towards the goal of coming up with new therapies for our patients. And it's a privilege to be part of that team.
I've always wanted to be part of something greater than myself. And this trial gives me a perfect opportunity to do that.